We are in week 5 of our DaVinci Resolve tutorial series. Let's talk about sound design. Hey everybody, Jay Lippman here. Welcome back to yet another video. If you're new to the channel and you're into things like video editing tutorials, gear reviews, and the occasional vlog, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. We are in the home stretch, guys. We are almost there. Let's talk about sound design. Like I said in the beginning of this video, this is part 5 in a 6-part series. So if you're new to DaVinci Resolve and you don't know how to set up a project, put a timeline together, color grade, and add transitions and effects, make sure that you click the link in the description of this video, go back, watch the first 4 parts of this series, and then come back here and get caught up on sound. In this video, I'm gonna take you through a little bit of the theory when it comes to mixing audio. We're gonna talk about the basic levels you want everything to be at, and I'm gonna show you some tips and tricks to get some really nice sound out of your dialogue and your entire video as a whole. So with that being said, let's dive in. Now in the Fairlight tab, there are a couple things that we need to pay attention to, a couple things that we're gonna be working with a lot. First of all, here is our timeline. And if you want to, you can go ahead and toggle on your video clips as well. I usually just leave those off. Those are your sound waves that you can toggle on and off. Here are your video clips down here. If you toggle that on, you get the idea. But really what we want to pay attention to are our audio clips, our inspector, where we can change the details of each clip, our mixer, which is where we can adjust the levels of each clip. And if we want to take a look at our overall meters, we can click that and see all of our meters here. So the first thing that we want to do is normalize our dialogue levels. And this is kind of like color correcting, but for audio. We want to make sure all of our dialogue clips are at the same audio level. We want it to be the same sort of loudness. Now, there are 2 different ways that you can do this. One of them takes a little bit more time, but actually works a lot better. I'll show you the quick way first. So what you want to do is just highlight all of your dialogue clips. If you remember that audio 1 and audio 2 we reserved for dialogue, we're going to right click one of the clips, hit normalize audio levels. We're going to change that to -12. We're going to hit independent and hit normalize. And that works most of the time, but sometimes you get clips that sound really weird. So once you do that, you want to actually go through and listen to each clip individually and manually adjust the levels on each clip to make sure that everything matches. The other way to normalize audio is to just forgo the automatic normalization and just go through each clip one by one and adjust the levels so they all sound the same. Now, when you do this, I have found it more useful to bring the louder clips down than it is to bring the lower clips up. I don't know why, it just seems to work a lot better that way. And once you have all your dialogue levels where you want them, it's time to actually start adding some effects to that dialogue and making it sound pretty. And to do this, we actually want to open up our mixer. And when you look at the mixer, you see down here we have EQ and dynamics, and we have that for each one of our tracks. If we extend our tracks here, you can see audio 1, audio 2, audio 3, audio 4, audio 5. We're going to want to tweak the dynamics and the EQ for our dialogue. The first thing that I'm going to do is double click on dynamics for audio 1, and I want to add a limiter. And what a limiter does is it allows you to increase the gain on your audio track without it clipping. And this is good because we actually want to raise the level of our dialogue tracks pretty much as loud as it'll go before it starts clipping. And then when we get into our mixer, we'll bring the levels down a little bit. But this is going to bring up our low end in our voice. This is going to increase the low mids and decrease the high mids a little bit. It's going to make our voice sound a lot more full, a lot more lively. So to add a limiter, we're just going to click limiter. Makeup is our gain. We're going to increase that to 14. And then down here in our limiter, we're going to change the threshold to -15. Then we're going to bring our attack all the way down, and we're going to bring our release all the way down. And the reason why we're doing that is because sometimes when you leave the release and the attack up, you'll actually kind of hear a delay in the audio levels going up and down when you hit that clipping point. And we don't want that. We want to have a little bit of headroom up there, and we want the attack and the release to be super quick so it's almost not noticeable. Go ahead and X out of that. And then we're going to go over and double click EQ. And really all I usually do with EQ for the entire track is just activate band 1 and band 6. And to really explain how this works, I'd have to get into the science of sound and sound theory and all that stuff, which I will do in a later video, but this is just more of a how-to. I just want to explain to you how I get the sound that I get in my videos. Just a quick explanation, your voice resides within a certain frequency range. Below that range is a whole bunch of rumble and stuff that really just doesn't need to be there. And above that is a whole bunch of really annoying high-pitched sounds that really just don't need to be there. So by activating that low band 1 and that high band 6, we're actually bringing the levels of those unusable frequencies all the way down. Go ahead and X out of that. And the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna bring in our vocal channel effect, and we're gonna drag that onto audio 1. And I have a preset here called At the Desk, and I'll leave that there if you want to copy the settings that I have. And I named this preset At the Desk because I created it for a video that I filmed at the desk, but I have found that 9 times out of 10, it works when I'm recording outdoors as well. It just kind of brings up those low mids a little bit and lowers the mid mids and kind of raises the high mids a little. It just gets my voice sounding how I want it. It also adds a compressor in there, which brings up the loudness just a little bit. And for all you audio engineers out there and all you audiophiles, I know that I'm not explaining this in perfect scientific terms. I'm just trying to explain it in a way that people can understand what they're doing. All right, so let's X out of the vocal channel. And that's pretty much it for audio 1. Now we're gonna go ahead and right click over in audio 1. We're gonna hit copy attributes. I'm gonna go down to audio 2. We're gonna right click. And we're gonna go to paste attributes. We're gonna check track attributes and hit apply. And now everything that we did over here on audio 1 is now copied to audio 2. And for the most part, the dialogue is officially done. The only thing we want to do is bring down the levels. And here's where a little bit of sound theory comes into play. When it comes to audio production, especially at a professional level, you want your audio to be leveled correctly. Now, some of this is subjective, but some of it isn't. Some of it is actually best practices. For instance, if you take a look as my audio plays, you'll see that the audio for the dialogue was peaking up way between 0 and -5, and we don't want that. You always want your dialogue to be peaking in the yellow on your meter. You want your music to be peaking either at the very low end of the yellow or in the green. And then when it comes to sound effects, you want those also peaking in the yellow. You want them almost at the same level as your dialogue, and ambient noise again in the green. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to open our inspector. We're going to click on audio 1. We're going to bring that down to -10. And let's hit play and see where that peaks. And that looks really good. So then we're gonna move on to audio 2. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna lower the volume to -10, hit enter, move on to music. And what I like to do for music, because when I go into those cinematic sequences, I want that music to be almost as loud as the dialogue is, but not quite, otherwise it's just gonna make your ears bleed. So we're gonna click on audio 3. We're actually gonna bring that down to -12. And all the music is pre-mixed, so we don't have to do anything really there. We have sound effects. The sound effects are just those whip whooshes that we had. Bring those down to -10. And we're gonna bring our ambient noise. We're actually gonna wanna normalize first. Go ahead and normalize that audio. So negative 12, independent, normalize. And you really want to play this by ear, but I'm pretty sure based on the levels that I have right now that negative 14 is actually going to work really well for our ambient noise. And let's hear what that sounds like so far.
All right, gotta go work for my neighbor real quick. Then I got a meeting with a potential client. It's a busy day. Busy day. All right, let's go. So, how I became a full-time YouTuber. Most of you guys know that I was an electrician. That was my career. I was in that career for about 15 years with the exception of a 4-year hiatus, which I'll get into in a minute.
Now that doesn't sound bad, and as far as production quality is concerned, those are actually the correct levels. Those are production standard levels, but we're talking about YouTube mostly on this channel, and on YouTube, people tend to try and go louder. Don't ask me why, I'm not sure, but that's why sometimes you'll watch a super loud video and then the next one will be barely audible. Now, fun fact, YouTube has been going through the platform trying to normalize the audio across the board. They've already been through YouTube gaming and they're trying to move their way through the rest of the platform. Until then, we kind of got to play along. Otherwise, somebody might come off of a really loud video and then come over to yours and click off of it because it's too quiet. But we're not going to raise this by much. We're actually going to use a compressor here. We're going to compress the audio. So it's actually going to be more of a increased perceived loudness than actual loudness. I'll show you what I mean. So there's a couple more things that we want to do here. We're going to go ahead and close out our inspector. We're going to open our mixer back up because everything that we're going to do here is in our main audio track. This is where we're going to do the rest of our work. First thing we're going to do is go to EQ. Once again, we're going to turn on band 1 and band 6. I just like doing that. And then we're going to go in to our dynamics again. This time for our main mixer levels. And we're gonna turn on a compressor and we're gonna raise the gain to 7. Then we're gonna open up our inspector. We're gonna make sure that main 1 is selected. We're gonna drop that to negative 3 dB, hit enter. And we're gonna play that back and I want you to watch the meter. You can watch it either here or up here and you'll see that it's now peaking right around negative 5. And that's basically where we want it. Now, there's a couple things that you might want to do that I actually should have done earlier. Sorry about that. So let's back up. Let's go back to those dialogue tracks. We're actually going to want to change those from stereo to mono. And the reason why we want to do that is because let's say you're listening to something in surround sound, or you're listening to something in stereo. You want your dialogue, for the most part, to be in the center. You want it to be up front and personal. You want to hear it clearly, and everything else can kind of go off to the side a little bit to fill out the sound. If you have your dialogue as a stereo track, then what's going to happen is it's actually going to get spread apart with the rest of your sound. And considering the final step of this is to tweak the stereo width a little bit, we definitely need to change our dialogue to a mono track. And to do that is super easy. We're just going to right click audio 1, change track type to mono, audio 2, right click, change track type to mono. The last thing that we're gonna do is increase our stereo width a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and drag stereo width over to main 1. And I just use the enhanced separation. I just like the way it sounds. Don't ask me why. This is personal preference. Like I said, this is my editing style, my editing workflow. This is how I like my stuff to sound. You may not like it, but you know, that's why I encourage you to experiment and find your own style. And as far as leveling out your audio and adding effects and all that stuff, that's pretty much it. You're good to go. The only thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to move around those whoosh sound effects a little bit so they're better timed with the transition. But here is what our final video sounds like.
All right, gotta go work for my neighbor real quick. Then I got a meeting with a potential client. It's a busy day. Busy. Busy day. All right, let's go. So, how I became a full-time YouTuber. Most of you guys know that I was an electrician. That was my career. I was in that career for about 15 years with the exception of a 4-year hiatus, which I'll get into in a minute.
All right, guys, congratulations. You have officially made it through an entire edit in DaVinci Resolve. The next step is to export your file for upload to YouTube or Vimeo or wherever else you want to put it. We're going to go over that next week. So in the meantime, like this video if you enjoyed it, share it if you think your friends will enjoy it, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell if you haven't done so already. I will be back Monday with a brand new video. But until then, thanks for hanging out, and I will talk to you later. See ya.